Today we have a discussion with Hashem over several practical cases. For example, Kohen, as we learned in the past, have a certain requirements when it's come to marriage. What happens if engaged with someone who's total in the status of pikeach, meaning a person who's a total alert, comprehensible, someone that you can communicate in a total manner of proper communication, and then between the engagement and the marriage turn to be blemish, such as death, etc. How you treat it? Second, it's what happened in the case of rape in a regular husband-wife. God forbid, the wife come before us and she was raped. How you treated the relationship afterward, not only in a matter of husband and wife, but especially if the husband is a Kohen. So we are, page 56, second line from the top of the page, Echad ha-me'are ve'echad ha-gomer kana, as I explained yesterday, it will be some paragraphs that I'll rush the Hebrew and then I'll explain English instead of doing word by word. In the Mishnah we said, דרך יבם קונה יבמה, the way that the יבם acquired the יבמה, so there are many different avenues, can be in our language positive or negative. The Mishnah used the term shogeg, meizid, ones, meaning the cohabitation can be unintentional in a sense of forceful relationship, can be intentional, can be with full consent. So for sure it's not under category which is the ideal bia, but im kol ze, the Mishnah said yavam kana yevimto, that he, as far as the dry halakha bid deoraita, by the biblical terms, so the manner of acquisition took place bame. So the big question left is, she considering ishto gmura, which means a total manner of husband and wife after it's all said and done, or we put it in certain limitations, mugbelet. So we said maikana. So Tosfot tells us that we are back to discussion which we have day before yesterday, mitkaven o she'ino mitkaven, which means, regardless if it was in a total intent or the matter of relation was total beyond control, it's still a matter of acquisition. The only thing is, it's called bi'agru'a, which means, as we learn in a Mishnah in page 53, you do not have the proper kavanat kinyan, the proper intent, but by force of circumstance, it's considered as a acquisition. Rav amar kana lakol, Rashi tells us, three lines from the top. Be'echad min habi'ot gru'ot halalu, kana la lechol davar. It's a matter of total acquisition regardless. Vo'ochelet v'atrumah miyad im kohenu afilo alach lemdinat hayam ve'lo ba'a le'habi'a gmura. Even it wasn't a total manner of acquisition, she still can eat from the truma. Shmuel amar lo kana ela ladvarim amurim baparasha, which means not for everything, but only those manner that the Torah refer in a very clear way over there in Deuteronomy 25 verse 6. They said, Yakum al Shem Achiv. The Gemara tells us early, if you remember, on page 24, that that's applied, Lirash benichsei Achiv. Lirash benichsei Achiv, meaning, when it's come to, let's say, Reuven, Shimon, Levi, and Yehuda, even it was a manner of bi'a gru'a, still, as far as the inheritance, he is the one who has the right to inherit the property left over from the deceased brother. And another point, ulfotra min hayibum. The whole point of zikat yibum, zika ban between them, that's already no longer in effect, total annulment. But as far as the eating truma, that's a different story. So Rashi said, ulfotra min hayibum, the im met ולא בנים מאישה אחרת, if that fellow is no longer among the living but he have from previous marriage children, מותרת לשוק, she can go ahead and marry anyone she wish to, או היא מוציאה בגט, לא בעיה חליצה, doesn't need the next step of חליצה, או אם הייתה לה צרה, if it was a co-wife, Rashi said, נפטרה בביאתו של זו. Tosfot challenge that. Just give you the vignette of Tosfot. You have a big discussion. And then he speaks about the concept of Biagmua. He said, when you have Shogeg, Mezid, Ones, Ratzon, all those cases the Mishnah refer, that's Biagmua. But the question, big question, Tosfot challenge is, Ma'adin, שלא כדרכה, הערעה, which means not in a regular manner. Do you tell me that הערעה, Tosfot asked, is מעשה ביעה or not? If you involve with children, so for sure, they need to have a גמר ביעה, as we discussed yesterday. But the question is, האם התחלה זה סיבה לקנות? Which means if they have the beginning process, it's considering a total acquisition. So it's a long discussion in Tosfot. If you go by Rashi, you do not have neither way. En ra'aya lekan u lechan. You don't have any proof either way. But the end of the Tosfot, who said, ubirushalmi ika pluktaihu, ve'ika demuke pluktaihu ve'ara'a. So the Yerushalmi elaborates on this point. Anyway, min ha'nisuim, the Gemara limited now the disputation. And they said, if she was married at the time that the husband passed, so לדברי הכל, אחלה, if it was ביעה גמורה, so she can eat from the תרומה, דה קבה אחלה מעיקרה, because now she turned to the original state, since she is שומרת יבם, she is waiting for יבום וחליצה, and the koach hakinyan batel, which is something that we will discuss on page 67b, especially in Tosfot over there, so she, biblically speaking, cannot eat from the truma. But as far as the marechet kinyanim, as far as the relationship between them, so you see here, plige, the disputation, mina erusin. So again, in Mitzvah Shem, in Tractate Ketubot, page 56, you see a big discussion. It's a machloket, why the sages put a decree that when it's come only to engagement, she's not eating from the truma. So it's a, one view is over there, I'll just give you again the vignette, that's a little bit. The Gemara in Ketubot 56 said that if they engaged, and all of a sudden, he bring her a wine, right? Says, look, this is expensive, go, very tasty wine, right? And she likes the wine, she get it from the Kohen, and now she go to her family, she says, come, you got to taste this wine, right? So there is a concept that Torah said, Vezar lo yochal bo. Someone who's not a Kohen, a foreign, cannot partake of any form of eating, drinking from something that is total contributed for the temple services and belong only to a priesthood. Since it was an engagement matter, and she is in a process to be part of the Kohen's life, yet the family is not, and we have a concern, so the sages came in and put a gzera de rabbanan, a rabbinic decree, that if they engage, she not eat from the truma. The Torah said, ve kohen ki ikne, kinyan kaspo, which means all his matter of acquisition, that meaning including wife, הוא יאכל בו. הוא יאכל בו is including his servant. So here we said מן האירוסין. מן האירוסין meaning that she fell to a state of yibum only from the time, so her first husband died while she was still an arusa before he had performed nisuim. So he lo knasa. Only his brother said areat mikudeshet li, only. So Rav amar, so Rav hold that because it's an inferior yibum, so she returned to the original state. אוכלת דהרבי רחמנה ביד שוגג כמזין. ושמואל אמר כי רבי רחמנה לא הוקם במקום בעל, העלום אם היא בעל לא. So making the yavam relationship with her stronger than that of the deceased husband. Because he did not include the ביעה גרועה, the inferior form of yibum, as an effective. So now you see that the arusa was not permitted to eat the truma while married to her first husband. She remained forbidden to eat after the inferior form of yibum. ואז דה שמואל את האמר. And Shmuel have his own reasoning that דאמר רב נחמן אמר שמואל כל שהבעל מאכיל, which means if it was before passing, if it was the original state, so the first Baal, he is the one who's ma'achil, ma'aval ma'achil, even in a bi'ah gru'a, even inferior, the yavam can go, v'chol she'en ha'bal ma'achil, yavam eno ma'achil. So basically you see here the disputation between Rav and Shmuel. Rav said be'usin she'ochelet, and Shmuel said no, meitive. בת ישראל פיקחת שנתעשרה לכהן פיקח. That's sad story. They are both in a total state of mind. Can be, God forbid, accident. Can be wrong medication. Can be a lot of things that happen in life. You have enough, even nowadays, that is a famous Gemara in Brochus. I hope the doctors forgive me, but the Gemara said, Tov shebarofim legeinom. Right, so sometimes with all the best intent, it's enough that you make a wrong evaluation and you're feeding the patient with the wrong medication. So sometimes there is an effect, a side effect, another effect, and sometimes affect the brain, God forbid, of a person, the neurological state. In any case, here we talk about Bat Israel Pikachat, a normal Jewish girl. She engaged to Kohen. So biblically speaking, part of the condition, they need to pass the age of mitzvot, and they need to have total pikhim, total, they didn't need to have a high IQ, but they need to be in a state that they understand what they are doing, and therefore their matter of kinyanim, acquisition, taking effect. So if she is a minor, the father does that for her. If he is old enough and understand enough, okay? So they said here, ולא יספיק לקונסה, because אירוסין is the קניין, but the חופה of נישואים, that's the final stage, עד שנתחרש. So biblically speaking, we said חרש is the same as שוטה, incurable, which means someone who's not in a total mental state, so even he cannot hear, it's not the same state. So we have a discussion on page 112b how far you go with that, but the sages put a special decree that someone whose death can do a manner of kiddushin and nisuim. But again, if you read page 112b, biblically speaking, that's not in effect, that manner of betrothal. So it said ולא יספיק לקונסה עד שנתחרש. אינה אוכלת, so she's now in the same state as before, because she's not married to him, and he is now the same as שוטה, so she cannot eat from the תרומה. מת ונפנה לפני אבם חרש, if the first one passed, and now she have a יבם that he is death, אוכלת. Why? So basically we said that there's no difference between Bi'at Shogeg to Yibum by the someone who's dead doesn't have the understanding. So it doesn't have the matter of the intent, and therefore Ochelet. So here they tell us that because you have a matter of Erusin that is in total midat, so therefore, so the power of the Avam is superior to the power of the husband. So deaf-mute husbands, with her, it's not rendered her permitted to eat truma. You see here, so because it's Erusin midat, so Yibum, he is eating the truma. So they said, Bishlama l'rav nicha. So we understand, according to Rav, because it's considering Bi'agmua, so she can use that truma. Ela l'shmuel kashya. Because Shmuel hold that as long as the husband is alive and she didn't eat from the truma, so the Yavam cannot feed her, give her with this manner of inferior Bi'ah. So how come in the Braita they say the other way? But they say that if you have a Bi'at Yavam Cheresh, so you feel in a Trumal, even she didn't do it with the husband. Amalach Shmuel Eima Hachi. Shmuel explained as follows. So again, she was Pikeach, Pekachat, Velo Yispik Lechonsa, Ad Shenit Charesh, and did not have the opportunity to marry her with Nisuin before he became a death mute. So again, as we explained earlier, he changed the status. Einah ochelet betruma. So again, she cannot eat the truma. Kanas, which means he's total badat. Ve'achar kach nitcharesh, so you have here chasur emechasra. Ochelet met ve'nafla, if it was badat, and she fall for Yibum lifnei avam cheiresh, ochelet, which means she began the process when the husband was alive. So therefore, even it's bi'agrua, it's still taking the fed. Umay bezo, what does that mean? We use the term bezo yafe koach hayavam mikoach habal, as we said. That's because he's also a death, Rashi said. Dilu bal cheresh mi'ikara lo ochelet. Because the husband was before the marriage, before the nisuin, he was death. Ve'ilu beYavam cheresh mi'ikara achla. But in the case of Yavam, even if he is a death mute before the start, she may eat truma once he performed the ibum to her. So you see here, up to this point is chelek rishon, is the first part. So if it's come to nisuin, kule alma lo plige, everyone agreed that if it's bi'agrua or chelek truma, if it's erusin, it's a machloket between Rav and Shmuel. Ika de amri. So there are those who said, what is the disputation between Rav and Shmuel? Mina erusin, that she was engaged at the time that the husband passed. Ledivrei hakol lo achla. So according to everyone, it's a, if it was a bi'agrua, she cannot eat from the truma. V'halo achla b'chayei bal, since she wasn't originally, by the time the first husband was alive. So therefore, bi'agrua is not taking an effect, only to put the avam instead of a husband and nothing else. So for sure, there is a Tosfot Rosh that have a discussion why if you have bi'agrua, you still not consider the same as regular because you have ma'aseh kinyan. Anyway, ki plige, the disputation between Rav and Shmuel, it's in the case mina nisuin, meaning she was married at the time that the husband passed, and then it was relation with the avam with bi'agrua. Rav amar ochelet deha hava achlat miikara, because when she was together with the late husband, she ate. So since you have an addition, bi'agrua, So she go back and eats. ושמול אמר אינה אוכלת. Even she used to do it with the husband. כי רבי רחמנה ביאת שוגג כמייזיד. Which means if, as we discussed earlier and yesterday, if it wasn't the intent, so they said לדברים האמורים בפרשה. Remember we talk about inheritance? So even you have a manner of bi'ah gru'a, but still as far the inheritors that you have the manner of the Yavan that he inherited the property of his late brother, and therefore she is exempt from the yibum. Aval lechol milei lo. So it means that if it was a manner of bi'ah gru'a, she cannot eat from the truma until it turned to a matter of bi'ah gmura. Ve'amar Rav Nachman, amar Shmuel, kol she'abal ma'achil ya'avah ma'achil. So now we ask a question that you tell me that Shmuel hold that she is not eating from the truma by having bi'ah gmura, even she used to do it with her husband. Rav Nachman, name of Shmuel, said that as long as they marry the same way at the time of the marriage, so if he passed Yavah Ma'achil, even Bi'ah Gru'a, so why he is not? Eima, you may said Kol Bi'ah Sha'bal Ma'achil, which means it's only for those dinim that come from that parasha. The Ramban challenged that, but Yava Ma'achil, V'chol Bi'ah She'en Abal Ma'achil Ba, En Ayava Ma'achil Ba. So, meaning, if you have Bi'ah Gru'a, when it's come to idea of Kinyanim, matter of transaction between parties, it's not sufficient to have Kinyan Nisu'in, Meitivei. Bait Yisrael Pikachat Shenitarsa Lekohen Pikach, V'lo Yispik Lekonsad Shenitcharesh. As we said earlier, all of a sudden, in between, he turned to be death mute. Eina ochelet. Okay? Because if you allow in Nisuei Cheresh, people come and allow Nisuei Cheresh. Met, if this death mute passed, ונפלה לפי אבם חרש, now the brother is death mute, ochelet, ובזה יפה כוח יבא מכוח הבעל, as we explained earlier. בישלמה לרב, so Yerubav said that if it's come to the time of the Erusin, Bi'ah Gru'a is not advanced to eat in the Truma. So you understand this. That is the same Arusa that didn't eat at the time of the life of the husband. Metaretz ki letaritz meikar el lishmuel kashya. So you want to say the kashya. So it's meaning that it's not a tuvta, it's just a challenge point. Because if you go, the Ritva said, the end of the Braita, even according to Rav, it's Braita Meshubeshet. It's a challenge Braita, the way it's written. Anyway, Tanu Rabbanan. Bat Yisrael Pikachat, Shenitarsa Lekohen Pikach. As we said, if the mentally competent daughter of Israel became betrothed with Rusin, to a mentally competent Kohen, ולא הספיק לחונסת שנתחרש, and he did not have the opportunity to marry her with נישואים before he became a death mute. So here, אינה אוכלת. She cannot eat the truma. נולד לבן, meaning if it was a ביאה גרועה, אוכלת. So the idea of אוכלת, so the explanation is not because of the husband, it's because of the son. The son made it. And then, metaben, which means his father, who's a death mute, is still alive, but the son passed away. Rabbi Natan omer, ochelet. Rabbi Natan says, she may continue to eat truma. So, and, v'chachamurim ena ochelet, since she didn't eat earlier, she not eat now. אמר לה אביי, אלא מעתה, בת ישראל שנישאת לכהן ומתלי, תאכול שהרי כבר אכלה. So come on. So then you go in a regular case. If the Kohen pass, with no children, she continue to eat בתרומה. because the din is if Bat Israel married to Kohen and the husband passed with no children, she stopped eating from the truma. So you can't say it. Ela kevan de mitlei, pakal kedushatei minei. The moment the husband passed away, as far as the eating truma, other matters, it's a different story, property, etc. But when it comes to eating truma, it's only by the manner of married to be part of the Kohen's life. If he's dead and he's no children, so he's no longer, in effect, and he cannot longer eat from the consecrated truma. So they said, now we try to compare to this, and said, Hachaname kevan de mitlei, since the son passed, pakak dushatei minei. So once the child died, his Kohanic sanctity is removed from his mother, and she is no longer may eat truma. So you see that Rabbi explanations of Rabbi Natan's position, it cannot be unintelligible. So they said, so since we rejected the explanation of Rabba in the view of Rabbi Natan, since we say that Abaye proved that after the husband passed away, there is no longer the sanctity of the priesthood, and she go back to her status before she got married. The same way, when it's come to a passing of the son, she turned to the situation that she was before he was born. And the same way, up to that point, she cannot eat truma because of the husband, because rabbinic view is she the same as engaged. So now, after the passing, she cannot eat the truma because of the husband. Amar Rav Yosef Kasavara Benatan, Nisuei Cheresh, meaning someone who will betroth his wife when he's a total mentally incapacitated, and then he turned to be a death mute. Ma'achilin betruma. So his wife eating from truma, because the Torah said, as we said in Leviticus 22, Vechohen ki ikne nefesh, kinyan kaspo hu yochal bo. So meaning, so early part is different, but later, you remember we talk about the drinking the wine that she gives it to her family while she is engaged, and there is an issue. There is another view that said simpon, that maybe the husband will find something that it's blemish, and it's a kiddushei ta'ut, it's a mistaken matter of betrothed, and therefore the Gemara Ketubot 57 said that she is in a status of foreign that ate truma, which is a problem, etc. So here you see, ולא גזרינה נישואי חרש, עתו קידושי חרש. The majority of the sages said yes, but Rabbi Natan doesn't have this gzera. אמר לאביי, רביי said to Rabbi Yosef, יחי, if you tell me that according to Rabbi Natan, the marriage of Kohen, that he is a death mute, you allow his wife to eat from the truma, נולד לבן לעמלי. So what's the difference it makes if they have a child, the son? Because if, according to Rabbi Natan, she immediately eaten from the truma after she married because of her husband, what's the son makes a difference? So they said, Mishum Rabbanan, that the sages agree that she allowed to eat from the truma. Veliflu Rabbi Natan aleu bereisha. Why Rabbi Natan wait all this time until they bring the scenario of the passing of the son? Why he wait to the end of the braita? And now he was so respectful, he let them speak. It's almost like a board meeting, right? Mm-hmm. They let them speak and express themselves to the very end. And then he disputed them. So he said that she can eat from the truma, regardless if she delivered a baby and the son passed, or she have no children. Because according to Rabbi Natan, marriage of a death mute is still filling with the truma. Yachei litnei meta ben ena ochelet. Rabbi Natan omer ochelet. We just said it clearly, that if the son passed, she's not, but otherwise she can eat. So because you see here that Rabbi Natan intent to dispute the sages, because at the first close, before the birth of the sun, or the last close, which is after the sun passed, she ate for Truma because of the husband. So the order of the Braita not tells us that Rabbi Yonatan disputed, only the last close. So he did not wait in that manner for the majority of the sages to complete their views, and therefore it's a proof that he's not disputed the sages, only in the case that there is a baby boy and passed away, that she can eat the Truma the same way as she did earlier. So they said Kashya, we left a question. V'chen ha-ba'al achad mikol ha-rayot. So Mishnah said that also the same rules apply if someone have matter of cohabitation in any one of those list of the arayot. Amar Avramran, Hamilta Amar Lan Rav Sheshet. So meaning he didn't say halacha bifnei atzma, independent halacha, but he bring a proof from this Mishnah. 56b, ve'anhiru le'aynin nimatnitin. So he bring a proof from the Mishnah. Eshet Yisrael shenenza. Af al pi shemuteret lebaala, psula lekeuna. Now we're dealing with painful case. Case of rape. Okay? Married woman, meaning a regular manner of husband-wife, and she was raped. So we said, as far as the relation with the husband, she can continue to have a marriage life with the husband, by halacha. However, when it's come to a Kohen, there is a different story. If the husband passed away, she cannot marry Kohen. So Tosfot explained to us that you have here a big difference between ones to ratzon, which means all of that applies when you have a difference between manner of consent and intent versus rape if it's a married woman. But when it's come to other manner of arayot, Tosfot said, for example, if it's dodato, if it's achoto, sister, etc., there's no difference between ones and ratzon. Why? Because you have here ma'aseh, and the isur is also in ones, so it's the same as mamzer in ones, but it's still mamzer, meaning if you have a matter of cohabitation and it was a matter of rape, so you can say that she can go back and live with her husband, yet the child is still mamzer. So therefore Tosfot said that when it's come to ones, meaning a matter of forceful relation, it's lo nogea leznut. So that applies solely in Eshet Ish, that if she is in Nensa, Muteret Lebala. Keuna, it's a different story. So she's considered Zona when it's come to Keuna. Cannot marry a Kohen. Vetana Tuna. So Rashi said it's like Vetana Didan, the same idea. Vechena Baal Kol Achat Me'arayot, Al Achat Me'arayot Amrot Batorah, or Psulot. If one have cohabitation in any one of those list of Leviticus 18, Mai vechem, Mai lav loshna beshugeg, loshna bemezid, loshna beosen, loshna beratzon. It makes no difference how that happened, if it was intentional, intent or not intentional, etc., etc. As long as they have a matter of cohabitation, uktanei psala. So it means you see here that a married woman, it's part of the list of the arayot. So it means if someone have relation with a married woman, even it was unintentional, automatically he has make her psula lekehuna, because when it's come to kehuna, there is no difference between shar krovim to a regular znut of eshet ish. So the Gemara rejected, said lo, mai vechen aha ara'a. That's what we said yesterday. That makes a difference if it was with consent or not. So if it was in the consent, that make it her invalid for the keuna. So they said ara adema ilei madarayot lemei madarayot alfil leivama adaraba yevama alfil marayot dikar ara barayot ktiv. That's what we said yesterday. So they said elam vechen ashelo kedarka barayot adaraba ikar mishkavei isha barayot ktiv elamai vechen ashelo kedarka dechayevei lavim. which is almana, kohen gadol, grusha chalutza, kohen idiot, what she said. So, Maharsha challenged what we speak specifically about negative commandments come to Keuna. Tosfot also challenged the point here with a concept of Mishkavei Shama. Rabba, Eshet Kohen Sheneensa, if the wife of Kohen was violated, Baala Lokea Lea Mishum Zona. So if the husband kept the regular matter of relationship with her, so he received Malkot because it's the prohibition against the Kohen cohabiting with the Zona. Mishum Zona E Mishum Tumalo. How about matter of impurity? Eima af mishum zona. In addition, mati brav zera ve'ilo nitpasa. That's applied to ones. Asura ha nitpasa muteret, which means if it's a case of forceful relation, she allow. Ve'yesh lecha acheret she'af al pi shenitpasa asura ve'ezo izo eshet kohen, that she is prohibited to her husband regardless if it was with her consent or against her consent. So velav abba michlal ase, do you not treat it a prohibition derived by implication from a positive commandment has only a force of positive commandment? So how then can Rabba state that the Kohen husband receives malkot for cohabiting with her? Amar Rabba hakol hayu bechlal zona, all those list of women that they have relation while they're married makes no difference if it was with their consent or against the will. Hayu bichlal zona. When it's come to future relation with the Kohen, they are part of that category in Leviticus 21, verse 7. Because the whole manner of the cohabitation was be'ilat znut. כשפרד לך כתוב גבל אש לישראל והיא לא נתפסה, אסורה. הנתפסה מותרת מחל דאשת כהן וקיימה וקיימה. ויקרא דאמרי, ויקרא דאמרי, and there are those who go differently, אמר רבה אשת כהן שנאנסה, בעלה לוקה עליה משום טומאה. משום טומאה אין, משום זונה לא, אלמה באונס, לא קרינה לזונה. So again, you see here proof that wife of Kohen, it's not under the category. Because zonah in a general term, meaning a woman that committed adultery with a full consent, not in that category. Mativ Rabbi Zera v'hilo nitpasa asura hanitpasa muteret v'yesh lecha acheret she'af al pi shenitpasa asura ve'zo eshet kohen, that as we said earlier, she is now in a state of prohibition to kohen because to remain with her husband even if she was violated and not willing adulteresses by any means. So they said, "Velav haba michlal ase kaase." So, and the prohibition driven by the implication from a positive commandment has only the force of a positive commandment. So, how come Rabba state that the Kohen husband received malkot for have cohabitation with her? So, Amar Rabba kol ayu bichlal asher acharei asheru tamaa. כשפרת הכתוב, כשפרת לך הכתוב, גבי אשת ישראל, זאת תצנת הכהן, והיא לא נתפסה, which is a case of she was violated, אסורה. הנתפסה מותרת מכלל דאשת כהן, כדי קיימה קיימה. So she, the wife Kohen, she is stand initially forbidden as defiled, and she remain in that sense. So therefore, if there is a matter of cohabitation that followed that, so the husband received malkot, and that's what the Torah meant to said, say, לא יוכל בעלה הראשון לשוב לקחתה אחרי אשר הוא תמאה. Now we're going to the Mishnah. The Mishnah, the previous Mishnah teach us that a certain relation with certain people put boundaries with her from Mary Kohen from eating the Tumah. הנמנה לכהן גדול, גרושה הוא חלוצה לכהן ידיעות. So if you have a widow, Mary Kohen גדול, which is a violation of Torah law, or divorcee or chalutza married to a regular Kohen, min ha'erusin, that's what we study, page 53, remember that Kohen is prohibited to marry a divorcee. The chalutza, when it's come to a Kohen, is only rabbinic. So if the Kohen cohabited with her, it turned her as a chalala and make her forbidden for the Kohen and marry the Kohen or eating Truma. So they said, מן האירוסים לא יאכלו בתרומה. רבי לזר ורבי שמעון מכשירים. As long as they not marry those כהנים, they allowed, eligible to eat the תרומה. נתערמלו או נתגרשו. If these forbidden women married to כהנים were then widow or divorced from the Kohen husband, so they said, מן הנשואים פסולות. If they were divorced or widow from the state of Nisuin, they are disqualified from the Kehuna. Mina Erusin Kshirot. If they were widowed or divorced but only from a state of Erusin, they are still fit for the Kehuna by everyone. So you have here a big discussion in the Rambam and the Taz and others, how you treated because married women by majority of the people, the way that people perceptionalize that, and that's also the Chazon Ish said in Eben Ezer Samech Gimel, people treated her as a total married woman in a manner of husband wife. So even we know for sure that it wasn't a manner of cohabitation between them, still by the public eyes it's considered as a married couple. So there's a big discussion among the contemporary rabbis, even nowadays, I meant close to our times, the Abiyezri and other, how really treated a situation like that. Amar Rabbi Meir, Netanya Amar Rabbi Meir, Kal Vachomer, Uma Kiddushei Reshut, if permissible Kiddushim, Eima Achilin, what does that mean? So, I explained in the book, Rashi said, Klomar, En Manichin Otan Lechol, that Nan Lekaman, Ayrusin Poslim, Bekperek Almana Lekohen Gadol, Samech Zayin. So, you have here, according to our Mishnah, two avenues with the Rashi and Tosfot. And the second view is, it appeared as the centerpiece, the dealing regardless if she is a Bat Kohen or Bat Israel. That if you have a widow that engaged to Kohen Gadol, or Grusha or Chalutza to Kohen Idiot, so even according to a view in Ketubot 57, they have the time and they're not married, she, those who engage with the Kohen, she can go ahead and eat the Truma. But it's all if it happens beheter, which means in a regular manner of engagement. But Tosfot challenged that. I urge you to read more here. I spent a lot of time going over this Tosfot and Rashi. Anyway, so they said, En ma'achilin, kidushi avera, lo kol sheken, which means if you have a divorcee that marry Kohen. So for sure you don't let her use the eat the truma. אמרו לו, רבי לזר, רבי שיון, respond to him and said, לא, you cannot prove it that way. Why? אם אמרת קידושי רשות בקידושי רשות, if you have said that קידושין does not entitle the woman to eat תרומה in a case of permissible קידושין, שכן אין לו להכיל במקום אחר, because regular Israel cannot feed or cannot bring any form of truma, tomar bekidushei aveira sheken yesh lo leachil bemakom acher. So for sure not. So we hold if the one who betrothed is a kohen, so he can feed her with the truma, even it happened in a forbidden manner, as long as they're not married, and that cause to be halala. Amar Rabbi Lazar, Amar Rabbi Yoshaya, Tzua daka. The Torah talk about a situation that sometimes a person cannot have children, such as Deuteronomy 23. They said, Lo yavo psua daka b'chal Hashem. So the soon we see example of what exactly either a wounded person or crushed testicles. So Kohen shekidesh bat Israel, if he is Kohen and he betrothed the daughter of Israel with קידושין, באנו למחלוקת רבי מאיר ורזר ורבי שמעון. Now you see disputation between the rabbis, how you treated. לרבי מאיר, דאמר משתמרת לביאה פסולה דאורייתא לא אכלה. So according to Rabbi Meir, who says that the woman awaiting a biblically forbidden cohabitation may not eat truma, so therefore hanamei lo achla, lo achlat. So this woman who is betrothed to a main kohen, so she may not eat truma. Why? Because she is also by the Torah framework, she is forbidden in a state of forbidden cohabitation. Rabbi Elazar ורבי שמעון, דאמרי משתמרת לביאה פסולה דאורייתא אכלה, that the woman awaiting biblically forbidden cohabitation may eat truma. 57, הנמי אכלה, she's also considering קניין כספו, she's part of quote unquote acquisition, so as long as she's not בילת איסור and became חללה, it's not the issue up to that point. Mimai. Dilma, at kan lo kam Rabbi Elazar Rabbi Shimon atam, ela yesh lo la'achil b'makom acher. Aval achad ein lo la'achil b'makom acher. Because he is forbidden lavo b'kal Hashem, and all the other women forbidden to him. So any woman that he have any relation, automatically she becomes like contagious by not cannot touch truma, cannot eat truma. Lo. So maybe Rabbi Elazar Rabbi Shimon agreed that he is not fit, he is arusa, is betrothed by the truma. V'chi teima, hachei namei yesh lo le'achil, and you may say that here too, which means the Kohen who has the capacity to entitle someone to eat truma in another circumstance, but geirim, one who's the convert, so she is part of us, so there Rabbi Baile Rabbi Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Yoshaya velo pashit le. So it means Rabbi Yoshaya wasn't clear if Tzua Daka can feed his wife when she's bad gerim betruma or not, and because there is a possibility that it's not, we return to the same question, how come Rabbi Yoshaya depend that discussion of Tzua Daka Kohen in this Mishnah, while it's possible that this Kohen regardless to the circumstance cannot feed the truma, and that's different from the Mishnah. Itmer Rabbi Amar, Oil Ma'achila Belo, U'ma'achila Belo Yada'a. Rava Amar, Oil Ma'achila Ba'avada V'shivchuto Yotav HaKohanim. So the Mishnah tells us on page 70 that a servant, a Canaanite servant of Kohen, of Psu Adaka, can eat in a truma because it's considering Kenyan Kaspo like all the other servant of Kohen. So he said, "Abai lo amar kirava kinyan di ishut, mi kinyan di ishut yalfinan, v'lo yalfinan kinyan di ishut mi kinyan avadim." You cannot compare the matter of acquisition to the matrimonial acquisition, which was the main kohen betrothed, the daughter of the non kohen, from a permit to eat tuma due to the acquisition of slaves. V'rava lo amar kabaye shaneatam shekvar achla. Which means over there it's different, because it's already eating. She's already been eating truma prior to her husband's injury. But Israel, she said, the kohen will make. If a regular manner of case that she marry a kohen and then he die, so basically we said teichul, that she can continue to eat truma even if she has no children from him. Why? Because he said she kvar achla, because she was already been eating truma during the lifetime, and you see that that's not the halacha. So the Torah said in Leviticus 23 verse 13 that the status changed. The Gemara Nida 44 bring the source for that halacha. Rava hatam paga ki yanei. So according to Rava, he said that, well, the husband has died, his acquisition of her terminated upon his death. So why she? That's the reason why now she forbidden to eat truma, despite the fact that she was previously permitted to do it. But here, however, in the case of Kohen who becomes main and does not cohabit with his wife thereafter, so his acquisition of her has not terminated.
ויחם לשולוים מלאכי השולוים מלאכי.